जय राधा माधव जय कुंज बिहारी 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 जय गोपीजन वल्लभ जय गिरिवरधारी जय गिरिवरधारी जय गोपीजन वल्लभ जय गिरिवर जय गोपीजन वल्लभ जय गिरिवरधारी जय गिरिवरधारी वल्लभ गिरिवरधारी जय गिरिवरधारी जय यशोदानंदन जय व्रज जनरंजन जय यशोदानंदन व्रज जनरंजन जय यशोदानंदन जय व्रज जनरंजन जय यशोदानंदन जय यमुना तीर वनचारी जय कुंज बिहारी जय कुंज बिहारी जय यमुना तीर वनचारी जय कुंज बिहारी जय कुंज जय राधा माधव जय कुंज बिहारी जय राधा माधव हरी जय राधा माधव जय कुंज बिहारी राधा माधव जय कुंज बिहारी हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे कृष्णा हरे हरे राम हरे राम 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 हरे हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे कृष्णा 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 Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Jaya Radha Gopinatha, Radha Gopinatha Radhe. Jaya Shri Gopal, Shri Gopal, Shri Gopal, Jaya Shri Gopal. Jaya Gauranitai, 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 Jaya Gauranitai. Prabhupada, 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 Jaya Jaya Prabhupada, Jaya Jaya Prabhupada, Prabhupada. Nittai Gaura Haribo, 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 Nittai. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Narayanam Namaskrityam Naram Chaiva Narottamam Devim Sarasvatim Vyasam Tato Jayamudirayet Nashta Prayeshu Bhadreshu Nityam Bhagavata Sevaya Bhagavati Rottamashloke Bhaktir Bhavati Naishtiki Krishnaya Vasudevaya Devaki Nandanaya cha Nanda Gopa Kumaraya Govindaya Namo Namaha. Hare Krishna. So today we are reading from Srimad Bhagavatam, Canto 12, Chapter 6, entitled Maharaj Parikshit Passes Away, and text number 66. Yajnavalkyastato Brahmam. Yagyavalkyas tato brahmam chandamsi adhigaveshayan chandamsi adhigaveshayan guru ravidya manani guru ravidya manani supatsthe Arkamishwaram Supatasthe Arkamishwaram Yagyavalkas Tato Brahmams Chandamsi Adhigaveshayan Guru Ravidya Manani Supatasthe Arkamishwaram
Yeah.
गुरोर्विद्यमानानि सुपतस्थेऽर्कमीश्वरम् याज्ञवल्क्यस्ततो ब्रह्मा छन्दांसि अधिगवेषयन् गुरोर्विद्यमानानि सुपतस्ते अर्कमीश्वरम्. वर्ड टू वर्ड मीनिंग याज्ञवल्क्य याज्ञवल्क्य ततः देर आफ्टर ब्रह्मन् ओ ब्राह्मणा छंदांसी मंत्रास अधि एडिशनल गवेशयन सीकिंग आउट गुरो टू हिज स्पिरिचुअल मास्टर अविद्यमानानि नॉट नोन सुपतस्थे ही केयरफुली वर्शिप्ड अर्कम द सन ईश्वरम द पावरफुल कंट्रोलर. ट्रांसलेशन बाय डिसाइपल्स ऑफ हिज डिवाइन ग्रेस एसी भक्तिवेदांत स्वामी श्रील प्रभुपाद. माय डियर ब्राह्मणा शौनका याज्ञवल्क्य देन डिजायर टू फाइंड आउट न्यू यजुर् mantras unknown to even his spiritual master. With this in mind, he offered attentive worship to the powerful lord of the sun. There is no purport to this verse, so we'll take the next verse also. The verse is in prose, so we are not reading the text. The translation: Sri Yajnavalkya said, I offer my respectful obeisances to the Supreme Personality of Godhead, appearing as the sun. You are present as the controller of the four kinds of living entities, beginning from Brahma and extending down to the blades of grass. Just as the sky is present both inside and outside every living being, you exist both within the hearts of all as the super soul and externally in the form of time. Just as the sky cannot be covered by the clouds present within it, you are never covered by any false material designation. By the flow of years, which are made up of tiny fragments of time called kshanas, lavas, and nimeshas, you alone maintain this world, drying up the waters and giving them back as rain. Purport: This prayer is not offered to the sun god as an independent or autonomous entity, but rather to the Supreme Personality of Godhead, represented by his powerful expansion, the solar deity. Om Ajnanatimirandhasya Jnananjana Shalakaya Chakshurunmilitam Yena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha. श्री चैतन्य मनोभिष्टं स्थापितं येन भूतले स्वयं रूप कदा मह्यं ददाति स्वपदांतिकं वंदेहं श्री गुरो श्रीयुता पदकमलं श्रीगुरुन् वैष्णवांश्च श्री रूपं साग्रजाथा सहगण रघुनाथान्वितं तं सजीवं साद्वैतं सावधूतं परिजना सहितं कृष्ण चैतन्यदेवं श्री राधा कृष्ण पादान सहगण ललिता श्री विशाखान्वितांश्च हे कृष्णा करुणा सिंधु दीनबंधु जगत्पते गोपेश गोपिका कांत राधाकांत नमोस्तुते तप्त कांचन गौरांगी राधे वृंदावनेश्वरी वृषभानुसुते देवी प्रणमामि हरिप्रिये वांछाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपासिंधुभ्येव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः. जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासादि गौर भक्त वृंद, हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे, हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे, हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे, हरे कृष्णा। So first of all, I would like to seek the blessings of all the assembled devotees to be able to speak something on this exalted subject matter of Srimad Bhagavatam. And especially I am giving class after a very long time, so I am all the more nervous. Although during this lockdown period, I have been giving some classes on the Zoom and all, but there you are just sitting in front of a screen, and here in front of devotees, the lordships, I am able to do some justice as per my capacity and inspire myself as well as those who are hearing. So, and I would also like to maybe try to read this verse, which is the second one, verse 67, which is actually the glorification of Lord Surya. Although it's in prose and a little difficult, but still, even the shlokas of Srimad Bhagavatam are very purifying. So, Shri Yajnavalkya Uvacha, Om Namo Bhagavate Adityaya Khila Jagatam Atma Swarupena Kala Swarupena Chaturvidha Bhuta Nikayanam Brahmadi Stamba Paryantanam Antar Hridayeshu Bahir Api Chakasha Cha Akasha Ivopadhina Vyadhyatmano Bhavan Eka Evakshana Lave Lava Nimeshaya Vopachita Samvatsara Ganenanapam Adan Visarga Bhyam Imam Loka Yatram Anuvahati. Translation: Sri Yajnavalkya said, I offer my respectful obeisances to the Supreme Personality of Godhead, appearing as the sun. You are present as the controller of the four kinds of living entities, beginning from Brahma and extending down to the blades of grass. Just as the sky is present both inside and outside every living being, you exist both within the hearts of all as the super soul and externally in the form of time. Just as the sky cannot be covered by the clouds present within it, you are never covered by any false material designation. By the flow of years, which are made up of tiny fragments of time called kshanas, lavas, and nimeshas, you alone maintain this world, drying up the waters and giving them back as rain. Purport: This prayer is not offered to the sun god as an independent or autonomous entity, but rather to the Supreme Personality of Godhead, represented by his powerful expansion of the solar deity. So, in this chapter, which is entitled Maharaj Parikshit Passes Away, now after the passing away of Parikshit Maharaj, now in response to the questions of Sri Shaunaka, Sudha Goswami is answering, and he is describing how the Vedas, which were actually originally, it was this knowledge was revealed to Lord Brahma by Lord Krishna, and in the form of a very very concise mantra called Om, or the Omkar. And then Lord Brahma, he created the original Vedas and he taught it to his sons Marichi and the others, and they were all actually saintly Brahmanas from the saintly Brahmana community. And then this body of Vedic knowledge was handed down through the disciplic succession of spiritual masters until the end of Dwapar Yuga. And then Vyasdev, as is being described over here, he divided this Vedas, understanding that, okay, now Kali Yuga is going to come, and the people of Kali Yuga will not be able to handle this entire mass of knowledge together. So he divided into 4 parts, and then he instructed to various disciples, and he created the Samhitas and other breakers. And in this particular event which is being described over here, say Yajnavalkya, he was rejected by his spiritual master. Like yesterday and last few days we have been hearing how from Satyananda Prabhu and even from Rasparayan Prabhu yesterday, how sage Yajnavalkya, he somehow or the other, he displeased his spiritual master, sage Vaishampayana, and because of that offense, his Yajnavalkya was asked to give up whatever knowledge he had received from his guru. And then he is praying to the sun god, or the Supreme Personality of Godhead appearing as whose representative, represented by the Surya Narayan or Vivaswan. So like yesterday Rasparayan Prabhu was also mentioning this, and this entire branch of Vedic knowledge is called Yajurveda. So and there are 2 branches basically, because sage Yajnavalkya, he is praying to Lord Vivaswan, the sun god, and he is representative of Prakash or light. So this branch of Yajurveda is called Shukla Yajurveda. And because the mantras which he had learned from his guru, and later on he had given it up, and that was accepted by his other god brothers or the other disciples of Vaishampayana, and they accepted it in the form of this partridges or tithri birds, and which were black in color. So that is why that branch of Yajurveda is called Krishna Yajurveda. So we can see here, like it's mentioned in the purport also, Surya Dev or Surya Narayan or Vivaswan is an authorized representative of the Supreme Personality of Godhead, and to impart this Vedic knowledge. Like even in Bhagavad Gita we see Krishna in chapter 4, he is explaining to Arjuna that imam vivashvate yogam proktavanaham avyayam vivaswan mana vipraha manurikshvakave bravit. The Personality of Godhead, Lord Krishna, said, I instructed this imperishable science of yoga to the sun god Vivaswan, and Vivaswan instructed it to Manu, the father of mankind, and Manu in turn instructed it to Ikshvaku. So Prabhupada in the purport, he explains that herein we can see the history of Bhagavad Gita, that how it is not something which was spoken at that point of time or invented or researched at that point of time, but this is a knowledge which Lord Krishna had given long time back to the sun god. And Prabhupada explains, sun is like the king of all the planets. And this knowledge, and he, the sun is responsible for the protection and maintenance of all the inhabitants. And therefore, just like the Kshatriyas, they are also given this responsibility of taking care of all the inhabitants and citizens, and to protect them from material bondage. So similarly, here Lord Krishna, he gave this knowledge to Vivaswan so that he is like the authorized representative, and he can ensure that the purpose of human life, which is meant for the cultivation of spiritual knowledge, and in and reconnecting with the eternal, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, and the executive, various executive heads of the states and all planets, they are obliged to impart this knowledge to their inhabitants or their people who are under their care. And this is the purpose of this entire Vedic knowledge. So we can see, like Lord Krishna, he establishes various distribution channels, like for disseminating this knowledge. We see, like, even in this material world, like, there are so many companies, they establish various distribution channels so that whatever product they are manufacturing, that can reach to the ultimate consumers who are needing these products. So there are different ways, like there are authorized representatives, or there are distributors, there are source selling agents, or like, and sometimes the company also sets up their own company-owned shops. Like some few years back, when I was serving in the vehicle department also, that time one of our congregation devotees, he had mentioned to me that you are going to various petrol pumps for filling fuel in your vehicles. So you should, if you go to other petrol pumps, maybe they may be doing some adulteration, or they may manipulate in the, if you ask for 1 liter, they may not give exactly, they may do some adjustment, just to increase their own profits. But if you go to a company-owned shop, then there this type of risk is less. Why? Because the company is handling it. They are not, the people who are working over there, they are not interested in making, in doing something in the system and all, manipulation. So that way, so similarly, we can see that Krishna also sets up various distribution channels, and sometimes because of some reason or other, some distribution channels may get adulterated or choked up. As Krishna himself says, that over a period of time, so kalena mahata, yoga nashta param tapa. So different channels, they may get affected or negatively. So here we see that Yajnavalkya, because somehow he displeased his immediate spiritual master, then he had to give it up, and then he approached the Lord Suryadev, who is also a bona fide representative, and here he is glorifying Lord's the Supreme Personality of Godhead in the form of sun. So the sun is ruling planet, as is explained in this verse also, and he is supplying us with heat and light, and he is rotating, as is also explained over here, that he is existing in outside as the time factor. Like earlier Pavneshwar Prabhu also explained the cosmic and the cosmology, and how the sun is actually rotating, and he is the main organizer, the chief, and along with him the other planetary systems are also revolving and rotating around. So, and Vivaswan, Lord Sun, then in Bhagavad Gita also it is explained, he gave this knowledge further to Manu, and Manu, being the father of mankind, he gave it to his son Maharaj Ikshvaku, the king of the earth planet, and he is also the forefather in the Raghu dynasty, in which Lord Ramchandra appeared. So we see, like, just like there is a sun god, there are also other principal demigods or representatives of the Supreme Lord. And even in the we see, like, even before coming to Krishna consciousness, I was like from a South Indian background, from an Iyer family, and we are also, our ancestors also trace back to this Yajurveda. We are also followers of, so whenever we offer obeisances and all, like we say our introduction, or we say, who is the person, whenever we offer obeisances or respects to any senior, then we have to introduce ourselves, who are. So we say the Abhivade, means I am offering obeisances. So in that it is said, it traces the lineage, which branch of the shastra you are studying. So Abhivade, Bhargava, Chavana, Aplavana, Urva, Jama Dakhnya, Panjarishya, Pravananyuta, Srivatsa Gotraha, Abhastamba Sutra, Yajushaka Adhyaya, Sri, then your name, Kashi Vishwanatha Sharmana or something. So like that. So that traces. So Yajushaka Adhyaya. So student of the Yajushaka, Yajurveda. So and even from the childhood, after the Yajnopavit ceremony, like is it will further be described by Yajnavalkya also, that in the glories of Lord Sun, that anybody who offers oblations to the sun in during the three sandhya, at the times of sandhya, like even in our Gaudiya Vaishnava Parampara also, like we are required to chant and the Gayatri Mantra during the three sandhyas. So, and the principal Gayatri Mantra is again prayer to Lord Sun. So, so these various authorized bona fide channels which has been opened by the Supreme Lord is meant to ensure that whoever is interested and whoever has different inclinations, they can approach different channels and access the same knowledge or in various levels. Like there was a very nice, and we can see in this form, in the form of the Vedic tradition also, like the Panchopasana, which is mentioned over there, the principal five deities for whom worship is or puja is done or respects are offered in as per Vedic tradition. So there was a very nice article which was written by Satyaraj Prabhu, and it was also featuring in the Back to Godhead magazine, which the topic is entitled, because I may speak only in very brief, but if anybody of you is interested, Many Gods or One, Five Prominent Deities and Their Universal Meaning. So in that, Satyaraj Prabhu, he explains that is Krishna consciousness polytheistic, a discussion on Panchopasana. And he explains that what are the various principles. Like at the first blush, Vaishnavism may seem to be a polytheistic, even given the various gods which are associated with Vedic pathon. But if we look slightly beneath the surface, there is more to this than the polytheism that meets the eye. The concept of monotheism, like monotheism or the only one god, that we may associate with Abrahamic religions like Islam or Christianity and like that. But and that is what is accepted mostly in the world, we see monotheism, but actually that is also very most pervasive and commonly understood. So the idea of one supreme god appears sometimes, in comparison to Vaishnavism, it may seem very difficult to reconcile. But when he explains that by these Panchopasana, where the principle there are five deities or five gods, like Durga, Surya, Ganesh, Shiva and Vishnu. And these actually, they represent the other various demigods also. But he explains that if we see these principal demigods who are representatives of Lord Krishna, we can understand their activities or their functions in three different ways. First, that they are alternative faces of one absolute reality, that the Supreme Personality, who assist in the administration of the universe. So these principles, they are in charge of various administrative functions. The second understanding is that in this service, they are separate beings performing cosmic functions. They are separate from the Supreme Lord. And the third, that they also represent categories of religious practice that indicate specific levels of spiritual understanding. So different, based on the individual spiritual understanding, they can approach different demigods or these principal deities. And this third or the lesser known perspective was the insight of Sri Bhakti Vinod Thakur. So Sri Bhakti Vinod Thakur, he was the one of the greatest Vaishnavas reformers in the past century during and his view on Indian Indic polytheism and how it interrelates with the standard monotheistic traditions like Islam and Christianity, That is, we will describe in little brief. So, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, he says that the initial quest for spirit or Brahman is in the form of a Shakti. So, we always, people, when they first get introduced or they want to know about, they worship Shakti or power. For it recognizes nature as divine. For the Shakta, there is more to what we see than meets the eye. Mother Nature is alive and fundamentally spiritual. In its most basic form, Shakta Dharma consists of worshipping Prakriti or Mother Nature. But it can all develop to more sophisticated forms like Durga worship and other demigoddesses. So Sri Bhaktivinoda Thakur writes, the practice of Shaktism are fit to give rise to the first transcendental aspirations of man. People engrossed in sensual development and apathetic towards seeking the absolute truth may be enticed by the practices of the life of a Shakta. Then, of course, the other next step, he says, when one's spiritual inclinations mature, one understands that there is heat at the center of all. We feel, we taste, we touch and smell. There is heat involved. So the sun or the Surya, he gives us life, as is explained in today's purport also, that the sun, he is nurturing us with warmth, light, and even in our stomach, like unless and until we have digestive fire proper. So doctors can confirm that unless your digestive power is strong, whatever food you are eating, you may not be able to digest. So even our Radhakund Prabhu was mentioning there the other day that because of this, now slowly as we are aging, so we need to control our diet. We need to see what food is good for us, what is not. Otherwise, whatever we eat, it may actually cause problem for us instead of giving us energy. Because the body systems are not strong enough to convert the food into energy. So when God consciousness grows stronger, the realization that the heat is preeminent power affecting all activities in the material world comes. And one rises to the second stage, that is the worship of the source of heat, that is sun, Suryadev. So we see this entire, like recently I spent quite a few months, 3-4 months in Govardhan Eco Village. And there I was staying in the Goshala and it was the monsoon season. And I was able to see Mother Nature in a more closer way, staying with the cows and also in the farm. And seeing agriculture, rice being planted and so much things growing over there. And we could see that the most important element, we may see that, okay, some may say that, okay, water is very important for the growth of living entities. Of course, water is important. Then the soil also, the Mother Earth, if the soil is not good, that is also will affect. Or if the soil is good and you give proper manure and all, that is also necessary. But one of the most important factors for vegetation or growth to happen is the sun god. Unless and until we get the energy from the sun, as we all means we have studied also, that only when the sun's energy is converted by the process of photosynthesis and other and it's made into food and then plants grow and all everything. So this Lord Surya, he is actually from time immemorial, from the dawn of creation, he has been providing for the growth and nourishment of all the living entities. And so he is one of the main principal deities. And then, of course, the next step, he says, after this, one realizes that the magnificent energy, great though it may be, is still mundane force, generated from subsisting in the material world. Bhaktivinoda Thakur calls this higher realization as Ganapataya Dharma. He says, this is that one understands above this material mundane energy, there is something more. And then wherein one realizes that living beings hold the secret to higher spiritual reality. And at this stage, an awareness evolves the animated living entities are more important than energetic abstractions. And gods such as Ganesha and other creatures, they become prominent and they become the object of our worship. And then this further evolves, then one realizes that all creatures reach a pinnacle in man as Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur writes, the fourth stage in the worship of pure human consciousness in the form of Shiva Dharma, Shaiva Dharma. Here one looks for an empowered personality, a more human-like divinity with whom one can identify. The idea of becoming one with the divine embodiment. And that becomes desirable and spiritually here consists of unitary recognition. Like Lord Shiva and Shankaracharya and all, they are all unity or oneness and Mayavad philosophy and all. That is the next step. Thus the Shaiva Dharma level of spirituality affords one a glimpse into the actual nature of the divine. And then the next fifth step. But there is a higher reality still, and Bhaktivinoda Thakur reveals the culmination of the spiritual quest. Coming to the fifth stage, an individual particle of consciousness, that is Jiva, serves the personality of Supreme Consciousness, the Supreme Lord, who is represented in the form of Vishnu. And this stage is called Vaishnav Dharma or Vaishnava. So he further informs that the world's major religions, like all the various religions, of course it is beyond the capacity of this class or even me to explain that, because that is fully more scientific and going into more study, which I am not so much used to. But still, I found this very interesting and maybe a little apt. So, and then further, of course, therefore, those who are simply astonished by the powers of anything in the creation, they are Shaktas. And then these lower grade persons gradually rise to become Shauryas or worshippers of sun gods, and or Ganapatiyas or worshipper of mass of people, or like they say, Janta Janardhan or Daridra Narayan and so on, in the form of Ganapati and other devis. And then the rise to the platform of worshipping Lord Shiva in search of ever existing soul and in the identity of the Lord. And after this, one may graduate to the stage of worshipping Lord Vishnu, the super soul, whose highest form is in the form of Lord Krishna. And another very interesting, in continuation of that, he says that to highlight Krishna's supremacy and indicate the secondary status of the demigods, Lord Brahma, who creates the material cosmos on the behalf of Lord Vishnu, he composed the treatise known as Brahma Samhita. And the Gaudiya Vaishnava Acharya, Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur, he is son of Bhakti Vinod Thakur, he writes a commentary on this, and he says that the Brahma Samhita has actually refuted this Panchopasana. Whatever Panchopasana, the worship of Vishnu as found in Panchopasana does not please Vishnu, he says. It is a heterodox and highly improper. The worship of Vishnu as one of the five deities makes his highest dignity, which is without any equal, similar to that of other deities. His lordship is counted as one of the several deities, which is actually a great spiritual offense. So this is what Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur, he's saying. And he says that it is the eternal duty of all jivas to serve Krishna, the Lord of all lords. All other deities are his servitors. Ekala Ishvara Krishna, Arasava Bhritya. Their function is only to carry out his commands. They will never acquire liberation who conceive of the deities as the different names and bodies of Vishnus instead of knowing them as his servitors. Thus, he quotes five different shlokas from the Brahma Samhita, which have described the nature of these five deities. So he says, as we always chant Brahma Samhita, Yat Chakshuresha Savita Sakala Grahana Raja Samasta Suramurti Rashesha Teja Yasyagnya Bhavnati Sambhrita Kala Chakro Govindamadi Purusham Tamaham Bhajami. Lord Brahma is saying, I adore the premier Lord Govinda, in pursuance of whose order the sun god Surya, the king of all planets and the eye of this world, perform his journey mounting the wheel of time. This is for Lord Surya. Then he says, Yat Pada Pallava Yugam Vinidhaya Kumbha Dvandve Pranama Samaye Sa Ganadhi Raja Vignan Vihantum Alamasya Jagatrayasya Govindam Adipurusham Tamaham Bhajami. See, he says, I adore the primeval Lord Govinda, whose lotus-like feet are always held by Ganesha on his head in order to obtain the power of his function of destroying the obstacle of these worlds. And he says, Shrishti Sthiti Pralaya Sadhana Shakti Eka Chayeva Yasya Bhuvanani Bhivarti Durga Ichchana Rupam Apiyasya Sachesta Chesa Govindam Adi Purusham Tamaham Bhajami. I adore the Premier Lord Govinda, in accordance with whose will Durga, his external potency, conducts her function as the creating, preserving and destroying agent of the world. And then, of course, about Lord Shiva, the famous verse, Shiram Yatha Dadi Vikara Vishesha Yogat Sanjayate Nahi Tatha Pradagasti Heto Yas Shambhutam Apitatha Samupaidi Karyan Govindam Adi Purusham Tamaham Bhajami. And then, Deeparchiri Eva Hi Dashantaram Abhyupeta Deepayate Vibrata Hetu Samana Dharma Yastad Rig Eva Hi Cha Vishnu Tayavi Bhati Govindam Adi Purusham Tamaham Bhajami. I adore the primeval Lord Govinda, who manifests himself as Vishnu in the same manner as one burning candle communicates light to another candle. Though existing separately and is of the same quality as the first. So here, the many gods associated with Krishna consciousness are individual living beings in their own right, and they are cosmic administrators, and they have an accessible down-to-earth function as representatives of the universal religious categories. And through Bhaktivinoda Thakur's lens, they offer the hierarchical understanding. Of course, for more details, you can refer to that article. And we also see in the everyday when we chant the offenses against the holy name, that the second offense, which says that chanting of the holy names, to consider the names of demigods like Lord Shiva or Lord Brahma to be equal to or independent of the names of Lord Vishnu. So we see that to consider Lord the sun god Vivaswan as the representative or empowered personality of the Supreme Lord is very much right, and to approach him for the bona fide knowledge is also correct. And even during like the practices which as I've said, from childhood we were offering this Sandhya Vandanam, and in that also there is this Hari Vandanam. We in different directions you pray to different demigods, and looking towards north, like we always in scriptures it is mentioned, for spiritual advancement and for spiritual knowledge you have to go towards north. So looking towards north, it is we offer this prayer: Ridagam Satyam Parabrahma Purusham Krishna Pingalem Urdhvaretam Virupaksham Vishwarupaya Vai Namaha Vishwarupaya Vai Namaha Om Namaiti. So, and then Surya Narayana Vandanam, in that also we used to send Namas Savitre Jagadeva Chakshushe Jagat Prasudi Sitinatha Kesh Shriti Nasa Hetave Trayi Mayaya Trigunatma Dharine Virinchi Narayana Shankaratmane Deha Sada Savitra Mandala Madhyavrati Narayana Sannisasana Sannivishta Keyuravan Makara Kundalavan Kiriti Hari Hiranmaya Vapur Dhriti Shanka Chakraha Shanka Chakra Gadapane Dwaraka Nilayachuda Govinda Pundarikaksho Rakshamam Sharanagatam Akashat Patitam Dhoyam Yada Gachati Sagaram Sarvadeva Namaskara Keshavam Pratigachati Keshavam Pratigachati Om Namah. So like that this prayer goes, which is part of all, this is all part of the Yajurveda mantras and the Sandhya Vandanam which we used to do. And also it is very interesting to note that even the Purusha Shukta mantra, which we offer as whenever the Abhishek of the Lord is done and all, that also is part of this Yajurveda. And it is also mentioned. And like in Bhagavad Gita also, Lord says that by all the Vedas, I am to be known. So all these Vedic, the branches, they are all, the purpose of that is to give the knowledge of the Supreme Personality of Godhead to any reader who comes to them. So, and so as was mentioned in this purport, that there are four types of living entities. So starting from Brahma to the leaves or so, and so these four types are basically the Shvedaja, means one who take birth from the sweat, then the Andaja, who take birth from the egg form, or the Bija, or those who take living entities who take birth from the seeds, and the Udaraja, one who take from the womb. So here it is explained that Lord Surya Narayan, also Lord Krishna, is the nourisher and protector, and the one who gives nourishment to all living entities, and many a times he does it through Lord Sun God. Like the same description is offered, or the stuti is offered to Lord the Surya Narayan also here by Yajnavalkya Rishi. And even similar glorification is done by Lord Shiva also. Lord Shiva in the Rudra Gita, when he is teaching to the Prachetas, then he says, Namo Namo Aniruddhaya Rishikendriyatmane Namah Paramahamsaya Purnaya Nibhritatmane. So it is also indicated in this verse, in the purport, very nicely Prabhupada brings out that Lord Aniruddha is the sun god by the virtue of his expansions. Since the predominant deity of the sun is an expansion of Lord Aniruddha, Lord Shiva also prays to the sun god in this verse. Lord Krishna, as a part of the quadruple expansion, Vasudev, Sankarshan, Pandhugna, and Aniruddha, is the Lord's psychic action. So whenever we want, there is somebody who's having mental disturbance or mental imbalance, or somebody suffering from depression, like then he's, if he prays to sun god or to Lord Aniruddha, then he gets stability in his mind. And we see Lord Sun God is always ready to help anybody, but he also reciprocates in the way, or Surya Narayan, he reciprocates in the way in which the person approaches him. Like we all know from Srimad Bhagavatam itself, how, like, and Mahabharata, that how Yudhishthir Maharaj, he was advised, like, by his guru, Dhaumya Rishi, to pray to the sun lord, sun god, so that he can, he is able to serve the various people who were, like, this is part of the Vana Parva, when the Pandavas, they were exiled, and they were to go to the forest and live in the live there. So many of the Brahmanas and all the people, sages and all, they all accompanied. So Yudhishthira Maharaj thought, I am now going to live in the jungle, we are banished, and how I will be taking care of so many people if they are coming with me? As a Kshatriya, it is my duty to take care of them, provide for them, protect them. So how will I do that? So then at that point of time, and this entire thing is being narrated by Vaishampayana Rishi. So like Satyanand Prabhu was mentioning, this is the same Vaishampayana Rishi who was the guru of Yajnavalkya, who rejected him. So he is explaining, and to Janmeja, and then later Yudhishthir Maharaj, he prays to the sun god, because Dhaumya Rishi said, is the sun god who from the dawn of creation, he has been providing subsistence and protection and sustenance, nourishment to all the living entities, you know. So you pray to him, and then of course sun god becomes very pleased with the prayers of Yudhishthira Maharaj, and he benedicts them and gives them this Akshay Patra, and says that this will continue to give you food and all other vegetables and fruits and everything till the time Draupadi, she serves everybody, and after she accepts food herself, then for that day it will not provide any further. And then we know the various nice stories linked to this pastime. And we also, but if somebody approaches sun god in a different attitude, then many a times we may not get the perfect result which is meant for the human form of life. Like we have this same example of King Satyajit. He was also a devotee of sun god, you know, and he worshipped sun god, and by the mercy of sun god he got this very powerful Shyamantaka jewel. And he was able to get a lot of opulence because of that. He became very powerful. When he would walk, it would seem as though sun god himself is coming. So he got those powers. But yet, because he was selfishly motivated, so he developed animosity with the Yadu dynasty, with Lord Krishna. And then we the so many pastimes regarding the Shyamantaka jewel happened. And eventually he did reconcile and he gave the Shyamantaka jewel along with his own daughter, Satyabhama, in marriage to Lord Krishna. But eventually it led to his own death. So the Shyamantaka jewel. So and this such a benediction, if it is not done with, if the prayer is not done with proper intention or desire, then it may actually cause our death also. You know. So in Bhagavad Gita, Lord Krishna, he explains that yada aditya gatam tejo jagat pashyasate kilam chat yachandramasi yachagno tattejo vidhimamakam. The splendor of the sun, which dissipates the darkness of this whole world, comes from me, and the splendor of the moon and the splendor of the fire are also from me. So in this purport, I will end with this. The unintelligent cannot understand how things are taking place, but can begin to establish, to be established in the knowledge by understanding what the Lord explains here. In this purport, Prabhupada, he gives a very nice explanation. He says, everyone sees the sun, moon, the electricity, fire and all, but one should simply try to understand that the splendor of the sun, the splendor of the moon and that of electricity and fire are coming from the Supreme Personality of Godhead. In such a conception of life, the beginning of Krishna consciousness lies. A great deal of advancement for the conditioned soul in this material world. The living entities are essentially part and parcels of the Supreme Lord. And he is giving herewith the hint that how we can establish, re-establish this connection with the Supreme Lord. As stated in Bhagavad Gita, the moon is one amongst the, all the stars. You know? Nakshatranam aham sashi. Sunlight is due to the spiritual effulgence in the spiritual sky of the Supreme Lord. So the sun, whatever shine, heat and light, whatever it is having, it's all getting it from the Lord. With the rise of the sun, the activities of human beings are set up. And they set fire to prepare foodstuff, they set fire to start factories, and so many things are done with the help of fire. Prabhupada is explaining in the purport. Therefore, sunrise, fire, and moonlight are also pleasing to the living entities. Without the help of, without their help, no living entity can live. So, if one can understand that the light of the splendor of the sun and moon and fire are emanating from the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Lord Krishna, then one is, one's Krishna consciousness will begin. And of course, like the moonshine is responsible for giving juice to the vegetation and fruits and all, everything. That is definitely. So without his mercy, there cannot be sun. Without his mercy, there cannot be moon. Or without his mercy, there cannot be fire. And without the help of sun, moon or fire, no one can live. And these are the thoughts which provoke Krishna consciousness. So in that way, we can see, like in this entire discussion, that Lord Krishna is, out of his love and compassion for the conditioned soul, he has set up these various distribution channels. He comes, various authorized agents and representatives, and who are authorized and who are entitled to share this knowledge about him and help the individual souls. And many a times, the Lord himself comes. Many, as we saw, sometimes distribution channels may have get some adulteration or there could be some problem with that and all. But sometimes the Lord sends his own representatives, you know, own persons. And sometimes the Lord comes himself, you know, to ensure that, okay, I will do. Then he can be more compassionate. Like we see, like when Lord comes as Chaitanya Mahaprabhu himself, like in this Gaudiya Vaishnava Parampara. Lord Krishna appears as Chaitanya Mahaprabhu to distribute, and he says that, oh, I want everybody to join in this distribution channel. And not only Krishna is coming, and he is coming, he is accompanied by the bhava or the love of Srimati Radharani and the compassion of Srimati Radharani, who is the mother. And he has set up this distribution channel, which is very direct. And then most important is, being the owner himself, he does not even see the qualification. पात्र अपात्र न देखी न थे कि स्थान स्थान एंड ही इज गिविंग इट फ्री ऑफ चार्ज है ना गोलो के प्रेम एंड ही इज थ्रू दिस संकीर्तन मूवमेंट एंड एस्पेशली बाय दिस स्पेशल डिस्काउंट ऑफर्स लाइक द पुरुषोत्तम मास एंड नाउ द कार्तिक मास एंड थ्रू द मर्सी ऑफ हिज डिवाइन ग्रेस एसी भक्तिवेदांत स्वामी प्रभुपाद दिस एंटायर distribution channel which has actually helped us otherwise we would have been in some other channel and it would have taken much longer time but here now we have come into the so called the express highway or the and we can actually access and maybe go back to the spiritual kingdom and serve in the service of Lord Radha Krishna in the most earliest time and also help in distributing the same thing to the all the other living entities also. So with that prayer and with that blessings, and this is all because of the blessings of our senior acharyas, our ancestors and all. So we can take this opportunity to express our gratitude to each and every one of them. So thank you all very much. Please bless me also so that I can do whatever service is possible in this with a sincere heart. Thank you very much. Granthra Srimad Bhagavat Puran ki. Srila Prabhupada ki Hare Krishna. Sorry for going over time.